Chapter 2, Electrostatic Potential and Capacitance. Electrostatic Potential and Capacitance. I am going along with NCERT chapters. Electrostatic Potential and Capacitance. If you remember, then in class 11th, we have done one chapter called gravitation. In gravitation, we have calculated gravitational potential energy expression, gravitational potential expression. That was because of the Earth and any other planet. Here we will calculate electrostatic potential energy due to electrostatic potential energy due to, of course, a charge. So consider a test charge Q naught or Q is moved from point B to point A in uniform magnetic field. Produced due to any other system of charges or single point charge, I say single point charge or source charge Q, and this is a test charge Q naught is moved from B to A. Distance of this point A is R1, distance of point 2 is R2, right? So let's calculate work done in moving charge from B to A. This is small distance, I can say dr. Work done in moving Q naught from B to A, dW is equal to F external into dr, right? Therefore, total work done W from B to A is integration of dW, integration of minus F external dr. That minus sign here we have to introduce because we are working against the field, and then limit goes from R1 to R2. This I am taking as R1, this is R2, right? Now solve this. Put the value of F external from Coulomb's law, Q naught over R square dr, limit R1 to R2. That comes out minus Q naught, you can take common, 1 over R square dr, R1 to R2. Integration of 1 over R square is minus 1 over R, limit is R1 to R2. So what you will get? Q naught over R2 minus Q naught over R1. So there is a change in work done, and hence change in energy is equal to electrostatic potential energy of point 2 or point B, and this is electrostatic potential energy of point A. So what we are getting? Electrostatic potential energy of point B minus electrostatic potential. So basically we are getting difference in electrostatic potential energy. And this work done actually is appearing in form of electrostatic potential energy. From electrostatic potential energy expression, we obtain net work done between point A and B is delta W is equal to delta U, that is change in potential energy, because this net work done is stored in form of electrostatic potential energy in the system by work energy theorem. So it is UA minus UB and delta W is equal to KQ over R2 R1. From here, if I say delta W over Q work done per unit charge, then this is equal to KQ over R2 KQ over R1. This is called potential difference of point A minus potential difference of point B, that is potential difference between two points A and B. So question arise now, what is potential of a point? Here we have talked about two potential difference. So what is electric potential of a point? Electric potential of a point V. It is defined as amount of charge to carry a unit test charge from infinity to that point in electrostatic field without acceleration. I repeat, it is defined as amount of work done in carrying unit test charge from infinity to point A, that point A lies in electrostatic field, without acceleration. So I repeat the definition again quickly. The amount of work done in carrying unit test charge from infinity to that point in electrostatic field again without acceleration. Now in that case we have to reduce point B, which is initial point, or point B we can make it approach to at infinity. So we have to keep BB mathematically equals to 0, and for this R1 should be infinity. So first point becomes infinite. That's how we are giving this definition, the amount of work done in carrying unit test charge from infinity to that point. So potential difference you can define at work done from infinity to A over Q or Q naught. This is the work done. Fine. So the potential is KQ over R. If we look into this figure, that is KQ over R2, or in general you can say KQ over R. So it depends on charge. It depends reciprocally to the distance. So when you plot a graph between velocity and distance of point from the charge, you will get a graph of 1 over x function. This is function of 1 over r. Right? So that's why these are essential to remember, that what is the shape of the graph of particular function. Then plotting of graph becomes easier. SI unit of this is you can calculate volt is equal to SI unit of work done is joule, SI unit of charge is coulomb. So if you want to define 1 volt, so 1 volt is equal to 1 joule over 1 coulomb. Now you can easily define it. Thus, the potential of a point in electrostatic field, or electric potential of a point is in electrostatic field, is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done by bringing a unit test charge from infinity to that point. 1 unit positive charge or unit test charge is brought from infinity to that point. Remember, potential is a scalar quantity. So in solving numerical problem, there will be no hassle because you have not to apply Vector's law of addition, subtraction again. But one thing you have to remember, that is conventionally you have to accept this note. Potential for positive charge is positive, while potential for negative charge is taken as negative. So potential basically measures what? What is identity of potential physically? If we talk about physical interpretation, then potential of a point is the measure of level of electrical energy of that point. I repeat, electric potential of a point measures the level of electrostatic potential energy of that point. Electric potential at a point due to point charge. Electric potential at a point due to point charge . So consider a source charge Q and point P at which we have to calculate electric potential due to this charge. In the same line, we consider two more nearby points B and A. Distance of point B, I am taking it as in between these two distance, I am taking as dx, and this is x. Fine. So start work done in moving charge from B to A. dW is equal to minus F external dx, right? So Q naught is the test charge taken. You can have minus K Q Q naught over x square dx. Therefore, total work done. Procedure is same as we have done earlier, except in change in limit. dW, integration of dW, minus K Q Q naught, integration of 1 over x square dx, limit will be u infinity to r. So you will have minus k q q naught, this is minus 1 over x infinity to r. So finally you got k q q naught over r. This is work done from infinity to p. So work done moving from infinity to P by unit test charge, KQ over R, by definition it is the potential of point P. So that's how you can calculate potential of point P. But remember, again, potential of a point is a scalar quantity. Numbers, first thing you can see, Vp varies reciprocal to 1 over r. So if somebody asks you to plot a graph between potential and r, this will be like this. You can easily plot the graph because you know what is the shape of the graph if function is 1 over x. Second thing, electric potential at a point also depends on epsilon naught because k is appearing. So Vp actual formula, when you put the value of k, is this. It means other factor is, what is the factor? Epsilon naught, that is a medium. So if medium between point and charge changes, potential of a point also changes. So we can say for any other medium, this is, we can say for air, This we have calculated for air or vacuum. So BP, B dash P will be 1 over 4 pi epsilon m Q over R dividing equation 1 by 2. You will get BP over BP dash is equal to epsilon m over epsilon naught, that is relative permittivity or dielectric constant. So there is a huge role of the medium for deciding electric potential also. So 2 points I told you. Number one, it is reciprocal to R. Number two, it is depending upon medium. Number three, for negative charge, electric potential will be negative. Is that clear? So you have to be careful. Now, if we have to calculate electric potential due to system of point charges, let's consider n number of point charges Q1, Q2, Qn having position vector R1, R2, Rn respectively, and we have to calculate potential at point A, O. So net potential at O you can say VO is equal to algebraic sum of potential due to Q1 plus potential due to Q2 plus potential due to nth charge. So you can say KQ1 R1, KQ2 R2, KQn Rn. K you can take common, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. Sigma I is equal to 1 QI Ri. So in case of n point charge system, you need not to worry about the vectors like in electric field. You can easily do it. Say for example, a rectangular hexagon of side, say we take one example, there is a hexagon regular hexagon having charges plus 5 microcoulomb on all these points, and you have to find net potential at point O. So if we say while this side is given as 1, distance between center and point is given as 10 cm. OA is equal to OB is equal to OC equals to OD equals to OE equals to OF is given as 10 cm. Charge on each point is 5 microcoulomb. Therefore, net potential at O. How many charges are there? 6. Due to single charge is KQ over R. So 6 into 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. Q is 5 microcoulomb. Distance is 10 cm, that is 0.1 meter. Solve easily. 6 into 9 into 10 raised to the power 9. 5 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. I am taking this up. So what is the answer? 2.7 into 10 raised to the power 6 volt. So here you can easily calculate because charge is 6q, right, and distance is 0.1, so you can easily calculate.